Hi all, welcome to the Things Virtual Conference 2020, the Virtual LoRaWAN Wall of Fame. I am Gautam Raj, Senior Technical Engineer representing Entu Technology Solutions India Private Limited. Our company has started in the year of 2007 and we are an ISO certified organization. We have well-equipped R&D team members for doing various LoRaWAN based product development and building various solutions. And we are also into an system integrator for doing various LoRaWAN based system integrator jobs. And we have enough facility for doing in-house product manufacturing facility, and we are also a technical and commercial partner for Dragino and Asalink LoRaWAN products, and also we are the technical support partner for the Things Network in India. So today we are going to see about the LoRaWAN sensor node LSN50. This LSN50 is very much suitable for all the LoRaWAN compilants. So as we all know, LoRaWAN is a technology where we can able to transmit the data for longer distance with low power and highly secured communication. So this particular LSN50 is very much suitable for all these cases. And in this entire session, we are going to see about how the data can be transferred from this LoRaWAN sensor node to the end application server. So here we are going to use TTI as a network server for decrypting the packet and forwarding the data to the end application server. So in this case, so this particular LoRaWAN sensor node can be used for various kind of use cases. So here I have listed out a few of the use cases. Few are like environmental monitoring, air quality monitoring, and ambience monitoring solutions. So this environmental monitoring can be very much important in current scenario in so many places, like it may be in smart office or smart cities or smart any kind of smart industry related applications, and also in insect farming and poultry and even aquaculture and fisheries, aquaponics and hydroponics, silos management and cold storage, brewery and wineries, right? So in all these places, if you take this particular temperature and humidity monitoring is very much important. So if you are using this particular product, we can able to interface any kind of such sensor to measure various parameters. So here for temperature and humidity monitoring, we have used SKHT31 as a sensor probe for measuring temperature and humidity sensor. And in this entire session, we are going to see about DS18B20 temperature sensor, where we are going to monitor the temperature factor alone. Apart from this, this particular node can be suitable for smart agricultural and farming solution, where the soil moisture can be measured in various levels under the soil. And also industrial monitoring solutions and smart security solutions also applicable by using these kind of devices. So here these are the few of the applications which we already developed by using this particular product. And so this first two, if you consider, it is LSN50 LoRa sensor node version 1 and 2. It is interfaced with SKHT31 sensor probe, which is capable of measuring temperature and humidity as a parameter. And next, if you take, it is a lux sensor, where we can able to monitor the light intensity of various places. Based on that, we can make some automation in the back end. And the last one is an agricultural sensor node, where we can able to measure the multi-level of soil moisture by using this particular product. So all these things are, all these products can be manufactured by using this particular LoRaWAN sensor node, and we can able to deploy it anywhere outside. Okay, and so these are the few of the technical specifications with LSN50, where it basically uses STM based chipset. It is STM32 L series of MCU. It has used with SX1276 is an option, and another option it has SX1278. So based on the frequency band requirement, we can choose whether SX1276 or 78. And also it is a battery operated device. It comes with 4000 mAh battery, so that it will come for a longer life duration if you are deploying the product anywhere outside. And also it have an option to monitor the battery capacity or battery level from the end application side also. And also it comes with IP66 waterproof casing, so that it can be deployable anywhere outside by interfacing just with the sensor. And also it have various few more options to integrate the sensor, like I2C, SPI and USART technologies, so that without any other extra modules, we can able to interface such a sensor directly with this LSN50. And also if you take, there are so many digitals and analog pins also there, So it have 18 digital IOs and two numbers of 12-bit DAC and ADC and one number of 12-bit DAC is there. And apart from this, it will work with the voltage level of 1.8 volt to 3.6 volt of DC supply with a very low power consumption. If you take the power consumption of this particular device in various cases, if you consider during the stop mode, it will consume 2.7 microamps, and during the receiving mode, it will work with a 7.2 milliamps of current. And during the transmission mode, it will consume 125 milliamps of current. So it is a very low power consumption of device, so that we can able to do such a low power device for the longer distance communication. So this is a LoRaWAN sensor node LSN50 of version 2. The major difference between version 1 and 2 is it uses an external antenna, but version 1 it has an internal antenna, as we have seen in the previous slide. So the advantage is it have a better signal strength and quality when compared to the version 1. The remaining all the specification are very same when compared to V1 and V2. So for more details, you can visit our website www.enthutech.in for more specification and about this product details. So now we can move into the things industries, right? So we are going to see about a small demonstration about how that LoRaWAN sensor node is transmitting a data from the end node to application through the Things Industries as a network server. So in this demonstration, right, so we can see, so this is a TTI account. So here first we need to register an application. So registering the application over here. And later here, now I am inside an application. So we need to register any number of device. Now I am registering a single device by using the keys whatever we have configured in the end node side. The same keys I am giving over here. So once it is registered, you can receive the data from the end node side. So once it is getting the data, right, so we need to give the payload format to decode the value. Right, so I'm giving the payload format over here. So this make the decoded value. Okay, so once the data is decoded, you can able to see the decoded value over here. So here you can see the battery value along with the temperature value. So battery values and this is the temperature value. So you can able to get, and this can be integrated with UBIDOTS by using an integrated platform. So I am now integrating this with UBIDOTS, and so this is the data how you can get the login the UBIDOTS platform. So like this, you can also able to integrate with your own application server by using any of the method of either MQTT or HTTP methods. Okay. Thanks for attending the session. Hope you have enjoyed the session and you have learned something useful. And so if you have any queries, you can ask with us. We will try to clarify your questions. Thank you.